see my wallet? Oh, no.
Never mind, I see it.
I think I'm gonna get one of those four wheelers that guy got. It's a little safer than the motorcycle. Domestic terrorism. Why you in the room? Yeah, me? You ain't nothing but a witch. Get out of here. No witches allowed. 1 Samuel 15:23. Rebellion is like the sin of witchcraft. Call it what you want it. Y'all think everything's sweet. All of you that's calling it domestic terrorism, get ready for homelessness. Get ready to be homeless. Y'all? That's what it is, man. You like it, understand it, believe it or not, man. Oh, you women, you got something to say. I know you would love to be able to get to my wives, because you ain't nothing but hood rats. And the other ones, you're lonely, and you got that rose that woman was talking about. You got a rose. You don't even have to do what I do because I'm a man. But you can't. You can't. You're taking it back to the Lord. Torah Center. Old products on that fridge? Are you really trying to tell me that? That's what you said?
Seriously?
Yeah, seriously.
I barely saw it.
Oh, come on, man. You lying. My son saw it right away. So, you know why? You know why I think you're saying that, really? I think you're saying that so if you did it, you could play that same role. Yeah, that's not. It's nothing. So, this is what I know, man. You said something to me. It's like, oh, I noticed you take really good care of your things. That's discipline, and that shows appreciation. People that neglect things don't really keep them that warm. I mean, they always breaking things. On the real, your pa has broken my work computer with the work files on it. I said, yo, don't leave that on the floor. Someone can actually step on it. A week later, the computer is broken. Brand new computer, broken.
Wow.
I gave the computer to her to use. I use this for work. She didn't have to buy it. Guess who underwent the loss? Who suffered an injury? Who sustained the injury? Kahan tells the doc. She said, oh, yeah, I'm going to replace it. I spent over a year and a half ago. The computer still hasn't been replaced. Vacuum at the other spot where we was domiciling that. The vacuum gets broken. I go and get another vacuum. She broke it. How come I gotta go and get another one? She broke the vacuum. We get to the townhouse joint. After about a month, she breaks that vacuum in half. You gotta hold the damn thing together to make it work. So I go and buy another vacuum and I say, yo, don't use this one. Mm-hmm. Now, I have to vacuum the floor because my wife is too destructive. Now she's trying to make it. See, it looks like to the public when you're on the outside looking in, like, oh, wow, he ruthless. But you breaking all of this stuff, you costing me money. To a bozo, that might be all right, but it's not all right to me, man. I don't like taking a loss. I don't like taking an L. That's what I'm saying. So now she started leaving the laundry and all of this, like just things left around. And she said, I'll get it. Yeah, you'll get it when? You've been saying that for 4 years. You'll get it. That's not proper. See, excuses works best to those that make them up. But I'm going to tell you something about excuses. You should know this. People that created excuses don't be successful because the two does not go hand in hand. If you want to be successful in this life, you can't create excuses, because excuses, you're just essentially telling me all the ways and all the reasons that you're going to fail. You already fail as soon as you create an excuse. That's what excuses are for. For people to fail, to justify their failure. To stop me where I'm lying at.
Right.
Yeah. Right, huh? I know right when I see right. If I see right, I'm gonna be like, yo, yeah, you know what, you're right. But if you're wrong, I'm gonna call you on it, because if you leave something unchecked, you know what, check this out right here. The scripture says that the Most High calls a deep sleep to fall on Adam And he created, he pulled the rib out of Adam, and he created Eve. So the woman came from the man for the man. But, and so if we looked at that spiritually, a rib is crooked. So if we leave it crooked, it will always be crooked. If we're trying to straighten it out all of the way, it's going to be broken. So we got to keep women in the scriptures. Otherwise, they're going to be like their foremother Eve and sin against. I thought you said you love me, though.
Don't you think you're kind of exaggerating, though?
I explain how I'm exaggerating that.
All he said was
talk back to me.
It looked clean.
But my 11-year-old son came up there and said, "Nah, I see the streaks."
Well, he was standing close.
You know what, women? Check this out. You know what you're teaching the children? We don't have to keep the house that clean. That's the message that you're projecting to the children. That's what's being projected there. Especially up there. Praise be the Most High. We don't have a daughter yet. Because she'd be like, "Oh, well, Mom didn't do it." She don't care what you say. It's what you do. She's going to go by what you, your actions, not what you say. Right, but you see, I'm exaggerating, man. Okay.
I mean, what I'm saying is, like, all I said was it looked clean, and then suddenly you're asking if I'm married to your pot.
But hold on. Did you see the streaks down there? Do you think it should have been left that way?
I guess not.
What do you mean? You guess?
I mean, she could have been using it still.
She wasn't using it. That was there when I walked in. I made mention of it then, and you was right there. You saw it. You heard me check it.
Well, she said, "I'll get to it." Well, I didn't see it when you were.
Let me ask you this. The other night when we came in and I showed you all of that stuff in the stove, mm-hmm. You seen that big burn mark
there? Yeah.
With all that sticky stuff.
Right.
If I didn't say anything, would that have been clean that night?
I don't know.
But was it clean? What time was that?
That was pretty late.
Yeah, it was pretty late.
To your live stream.
So when I call her, when I made mention to her on it, she said, "I'll get to it." Well, she never got to it. So I done a live stream, 2 hours. She still didn't get to it. So I went in and started cleaning it. And what typically happens, as time progressed, you would begin to see that when I start doing it myself, because by the time I start doing it myself, I'm pissed off. Yeah, I don't need you to do it now. But I mean, if the long and the short is, if I gotta do these wifely things, and the wives are just sitting around forming a confederacy against me, what do I need a wife for? Because I'm doing it myself, you see what I'm saying? A woman is supposed to be a helpmeet. I went over that last night. She's not supposed to be a smart mouth, sarcastic, with a razor tongue, but a help me. Supposed to be able to build something here. That's what I'm trying to articulate. You understand what I'm talking about? So if I gotta do it myself, I don't need a wife. All I need is a concubine, if all she's gonna give me is a vajayjay. And not really perform her wifely duties. That's what I'm saying. And that's what all of these men need to hear. Most of you men, you won't stand up. They say, "Oh, that guy's a tyrant." No, men are the most humble. A lot of you weak men, you probably watch him. "Oh man, that guy, yeah, whatever, that guy. Real man. You like it, understand it, believe it or not. Now don't you go and try it, because your wife's gonna smack you up the side of your head and embarrass you. Because you've been being a henpeck all of this damn time. You've been being weak. Don't try this in your home. You understand? I'm a trained professional, trained by the Ruach HaKadosh. And I know feminists are looking at this and hating. Oh, wow. Look at the word that the witch used. She say that's domestic terrorism. If that ain't a damn mind of a devil, I don't know what is. Let me, and I could guarantee that same woman would claim to be a Christian. Throughout the scriptures, the Most High said the man is the head of the family. The man is the head of the home. You know why so many of your homes are out of disorder and out of order? Because you've elevated Eve up with Adam. And such cannot be, man. Every organization has to have a leader. And men need to step back up and start leading their families. Esau has given all these women these jobs. And, yeah, I mean, she's elevating herself beyond the man. So the prophecy, Isaiah 3:12, is coming to pass. There's a new thing. In Jeremiah, it said there's a new thing in the earth. A woman shall compass a man. And this is what you're getting today. This is why I could have a witch come on and say, yo, that's domestic terrorism. Who in the hell am I terrorizing? You damn dodo. You're probably alone. Played a harlot. And living in a damn a hut. Call a ghetto. That's how you come out of your face like that. And your father probably wasn't in your life. And I'm probably cutting your spirit right now. You understand what I'm talking about? Understand this, I'm not here to be like. I'm here to be taught and teach what real manhood is. Role model for the young men and women. Because most of you women, you know what your problems are? Your father wasn't in your life. And if he was, he was sitting in the corner and Big Mama was running the crib. Big Mama was telling his wife what to do and he's sitting there quiet, drinking like David Dayton. Portraying theatrics. See, a real priest got the Bible now. See, when you self-sufficient, dig what I'm saying. Men, womb men, when you self-sufficient, and when you love yourself, you don't worry about whether a woman's gonna leave you because you're doing the best that you can, and you know that your house is in accordance with the scriptures. As for me and my house, we shall serve the supreme Elohim. Now you can like that, understand it, believe it or not. And this is why so many of you women, that's what Kevin Samuels be trying to tell you. That's why so many of you are miserable. You think you know it all. You're always running off at the mouth. You George Abbott. Talk of intent. But you're talking loud and you're saying nothing. You lonely. And you making love to a plastic rose or something. Sticking some foreign object up you. You dig?